There are concerns high-needs students won't get the right support after the shelving of plans to make it easier to get into residential special schools. For years now, roles at the schools have dwindled. Jessica Roden explains.
At a glance, this could be someone's home, but it's actually a school. Students with learning and behavioural issues live and learn here.
You need a high-impact intensive service like we offer. You don't get the change any other way for those students who require that support.
As well as Westbridge in Auckland, there's Salisbury in Richmond and Hallswell in Christchurch. The three schools combined currently have 29 students, but that's well short of the 84 students they're funded for.
There's not a demand issue. I mean, if you talk to mainstream principals, you will know there's a huge demand for the sorts of service we offer. So it's very much an access issue.
The schools themselves don't get to decide who can and can't come. Enrolments go through the Ministry of Education and the criteria is strict.
A year ago, the Associate Education Minister kicked off a plan to reduce barriers to enrolment. But that's been paused after the United Nations recently recommended New Zealand close the schools.
Personally, I disagree with that point. I feel that they can be part of an inclusive system, but I'm willing to see what the evidence suggests.
She's waiting on research by Auckland University before making any decisions.
Disabled people and our families need to hear that the minister and ministers for education are going to support disabled kids and their families to live in their communities and go to their local schools. If that means closing down residential schools because we need to shift the resource to support people at home, close them down.
There's been fierce debate about the schools over the years. Salisbury has twice come back from the brink of closure.
No one would argue against a system where every student gets their needs met in their local school. It's not the reality. There'd have to be some huge changes for that to happen. Closing our schools does not solve that problem.
The problem now for the minister to decide whether schools like this will keep their doors open. Jessica Roden, One News.